Welcome back to my YouTube channel Bad Book Thief. Asha here. Today we are going to talk about this book, This House of Clay and Water by Feka Mansab. This book was gifted to me on my birthday by a very dear friend. So Shruti, if you are watching this video, thank you so much for introducing me to this author because I absolutely loved this book and I know that I'm going to read it sometime again soon. Guys, before I delve into the review of this book, I want to request you to please subscribe to my channel. And please also hit on the bell icon so that you don't miss out on any of the videos. This House of Clay and Water is written by Pakistani author Feka Mansab. This is my first book from her and I am totally captivated. So this author is a Pakistani author who has written about the life of women, the life about those who are an outcast in the society, and she has written it so beautifully that it's not going to leave your mind anytime soon. This plot is set in the city of Lahore in Pakistan, in present-day Pakistan. It's the story of the eunuch Bhangi, of Nida and Sasha, these two women who are from conservative Muslim families. And it's about them trying to find out their identity in their family, in the society, and their longing for freedom. There are two things that I really want to talk about. First is the writing. Her writing is absolutely lyrical, it's poetic, and there are tidbits of philosophy that feel really well done. They don't feel preachy at all, and the way she does it, it tugs at your heart. Let's talk about the characters. I think the one character that really stayed with me was Bhangi. He is the eunuch. He's also called the Kalandar, who sits at the Data Sahib Dargah, and he imparts his knowledge. And people come to him, they flock to him for his solutions, and that's where he meets Nida. And what starts when they meet, and you know, the turbulence they face after that in both of their lives, I think is quite liberating and quite complicated as well at the same time. Bhangi is one of the most important characters, and I think the philosophical bites that the author has scattered all through the book through Bhangi is something to look out for. You don't find it preachy, and they are so heart-wrenching. They tear at your heart, and you are thinking about those words, and you're thinking about those emotions and feelings, and you're thinking, how can someone be going through so many things all at once? They want to be normal, they want to be accepted in the society, they want to be loved, and why is it all so difficult? You know, after all, don't eunuchs deserve a normal life? Especially what happened with Bhangi when, in his childhood, when he had to go through things he had to go through, and he was given away as a slave, as a sex worker. All that bit in the story is really moving. To some extent, those open your eyes to so many harsh realities that probably this particular community in the society goes through. So while it was enlightening, it was also quite disturbing, I thought. Sasha is a bold woman. She's all about labels and richness and the grandeur of life, and she makes sure that she fulfills all of her ambitions, material gains, by consorting with rich men. And and she lives a very happy life until a particular incident that happens, after which her eyes open to a lot of things. She starts believing in religion. She even starts wearing the burqa. And that kind of shows how ultimately religion and society force you to accept things that you probably have not given so much importance in your own life. So Sasha is all about breaking bonds, breaking stereotypes, but ultimately she falls into the same molds and she becomes one from the society. Nida, however, is a different story altogether. She is from a political family, and she's trying to find the meaning of her existence, of her position in her family. I think the mood of the book itself is very melancholic, and more than 80% of it, I would grant it to Nida. But all in all, Bhangi was the character who really stayed with me. He's one of my favorite characters. Some books are known for their plots, for their characters, some for their writing. This book, however, is different. I think if I have to name one thing it really stands out for, is the feeling, the vibe it leaves you with. I think what the author really tried to tell us through this book is that no matter who you are, no matter where you are from, if you believe in certain things, you believe in those things. You really do not have to conform to the society norms, and you do not have to adjust to, you know, conservative mindsets. If you are passionate enough about what you love in life, you should go after those things. There really isn't one thing that I felt was out of place. I never felt I was going through too much of anything at one point of time, or if anything was if anything was dull, or you know, if I was losing hold of the plot, or if the characters were not with me, I never felt that once. That's all about this House of Clay and Water today, guys. If you have read this book, I want you to tell me, how did you like it? And if you plan to read this book, I have shared the link for you to buy your own copy in the description box below. With that, I end my review of This House of Clay and Water by Feka Mansa. See you in my next video. Till then, be reading, be inspiring. Goodbye.